Thanks to these breakthrough technologies, people on dialysis will get a fully functional kidney without waiting years for a transplant. Hello, Katherine from Wearable Kidney here. Welcome to our journey together to a better kidney health. The waiting list for a kidney transplant gets longer every year. The only thing that can stop this organ shortage seems to be a miracle. There are 5 new technologies someone in need for a kidney transplant could use right now or in the near future to get out of dialysis for good. Today, we'll take a look at them, starting with the Bioartificial Kidney from UCSF. The Bioartificial Kidney is an implantable, lab-made organ that promises to do exactly what the human kidneys do. According to the researchers from the University of California, San Francisco, the bioartificial kidney is the size of a coffee cup and consists of 2 modules that work together and that are powered by the human body. Once implanted, the bioartificial kidney won't need any external power and it's meant to be permanent without the need for immunosuppressant drugs. This technology was supposed to be tested on humans already in 2021. It got delayed, but we now have some new info about the release date. The bioartificial kidney recently won a competition called NEF Madness 2021. The judges of this competition, a contest aimed to predict which kidney health-related concept will be the most influential over the next 5 years, think that the bioartificial kidney is the latest and greatest breakthroughs in the field of nephrology. Now, there are some interesting news regarding the human trials of the bioartificial kidney. According to the website of the University of California, San Francisco, the team is still doing a material safety test of the hemofilter, the most important component of the bioartificial kidney. And this is just the first step of many to receive FDA approval for a completed bioartificial kidney device. They expect to arrive at this final stage of clinical trials by late 2021. After that, and assuming that there will be no unanticipated events, they will start to test it on humans. They also have a waiting list for people wanting to be test subjects for the artificial kidney. You can find it down in video description. And while Dr. Shuvo Roy, project leader, still isn't able to give us a date for the human trials, there are 2 similar projects that are already being tested on humans today. Number 4, the WAK, Wearable Artificial Kidney. Let's imagine that instead of having to spend hours tied to a machine, people in need for dialysis could just wear a mini dialysis machine around like a fanny pack. This is what researchers at the Wearable Artificial Organs Incorporation, led by Victor Gura, MD, are trying to turn from a dream into reality. And I know that this doesn't sound as good as an artificial kidney that's actually implanted inside the body, but the best thing about this solution is that it's already being tested on humans. In fact, the device has been clinically tested in Europe, and since it can be worn under clothes, it has the potential to be life-changing. I mean, patients could be finally getting dialysis while doing daily activities they wouldn't normally do. This device has a battery that needs to be charged at night and many working parts, as we can see here, but it's only going to weigh 2 pounds. Right now, 3 human studies have been done with good success. And there are 2 more studies to go before it might be ready for the public. According to Dr. Gura, preliminary data indicate that patients on dialysis using the WAK might be free to eat and drink with few limitations. Most important, wearable kidneys can keep patients way healthier than dialysis. This is because they work around the clock just like real kidneys. This leads to better blood pressure control, less fluid retention, less stress on the heart, and less strict diet. Now guys, while this project is being tested on humans right now, We don't have a date for its release yet. What we already have available today is a way to get a kidney transplanted without a compatible donor. The paired kidney exchange program. This may not look as revolutionary as the implantable or the wearable kidney, but it could mean everything for someone in need for a transplant right now. It's really difficult for people in need of a kidney to find a compatible donor. This program is aimed at bridging the gap. Let's say that you need a kidney and you're so lucky that a relative, your spouse, or maybe a friend is willing to donate you one of theirs. Well, there's no guarantee that they will be able to do so. Kidney donors must have a compatible blood type with the recipient. If the donor's blood type works with your blood type, the donor will take the next blood test, tissue typing. If everything is fine, they will finally be able to donate. But if there's no blood compatibility or no tissue compatibility, there's no match. This may be finally over. To overcome this problem, an increasing number of kidney donors and recipients are turning to paired kidney exchange. In a paired exchange, an incompatible donor or recipient pair, such as husband and wife that don't have compatible blood types, are matched with another incompatible donor recipient pair for a swap. Each donor gives a kidney to the other person's intended recipient. This could be done with 4 people, 6 people, or sometimes even more. Now, what should you do if you are interested in a paired exchange program? Contact your transplant hospital or a transplant hospital that has an exchange program. I've put a link in the description to the complete list of hospitals in the US hosting these programs. If this doesn't work, contact an organization such as the Alliance for Paired Donation or the National Kidney Registry. They may be able to help you. And what to do if you don't have anyone who can donate you a kidney? Well, some people resort to buy one. Because while in almost any part of the world, it is illegal to buy or sell organs, Iran has a legal market for organ donors. The government in Iran offers people a legal way to buy and sell kidneys, and is the only country in the world to do so. A foundation registers buyers and sellers, matches them up, and sets a fixed price of $4,600 per kidney. Since 1993, doctors in Iran have performed more than 30,000 kidney transplants this way. Today, if you walk the streets in Tehran, you will read dozens of messages accompanied by phone numbers and blood types of people selling their kidney. While this could look like a beacon of hope for someone in dialysis, this system hasn't always worked as it's supposed to. About 23% of Iraqis live in poverty, meaning they survive on $2 a day or less. And many poor people fall prey of scams and merciless dealers. Because not all the sales of organs are regulated by the government. Hundreds of Iraqis are believed to have sold kidneys and other organs through shady dealers in the past few years. And we need to consider the personal, physical, and financial consequences for vendors themselves. They're not supported by the medical system and are often left by themselves when it comes to follow-up cares. Not to mention that foreigners are barred from the National Iraqi Organs Market Program. But in many cases, they still get organs from the parallel dark market. The illicit trade is largely lucrative for dealers who generally take 2/3 of the sale with 1/3 going to the donor. Some news reported of people who were forced to donate organs against their will. The daily number of human trafficking crimes in Tehran and other provinces is frightening. It's not something worth encouraging. On the other hand, something absolutely worth encouraging is the research on stem cells. Stem cells-based therapy is the most promising new treatment, in my opinion. First of all, because it can actually repair the kidneys, even if the damage is really severe, like for stage 5 kidney disease patients. And second, because it's already proven to work. The lives of thousands of children with leukemia have been saved thanks to the use of blood stem cells. Diseases that were incurable, such as heart disease, osteoarthritis, spinal cord injuries, Parkinson's disease, type 1 diabetes, and even some types of cancer, are now being successfully treated with stem cell therapies. And researchers from the Harvard Stem Cell Institute are actually testing several new therapies on people with stage 5 kidney disease. They say that a stem cell therapy for disease-related kidney damage has the potential to eliminate the need for dialysis. And while there are currently no FDA-approved treatments for kidney disease that use stem cells, there are clinics in the world already treating kidney disease with stem cell therapy. Or at least, this is what they say. If you want to know more about this, I have a video about this. It's up here. A new video is coming next Tuesday, and I really hope to see you there. In the meantime, keep taking good care of your kidneys and be good to yourself. This is all for today. Thank you for watching.